Hi, I'm Guillaume Meyer, a technical artist at Adobe Substance 3D. Today, I would like to present the new clone stamp filter we added in the latest version of Substance 3D Sampler. The clone stamp is a powerful tool for post-processing scanned materials. This updated version now supports new stamp transformation like scale, rotation, mirror, and a new fade blending algorithm. Let's jump into Sampler to have a closer look.
First, I imported this texture map from a scanned fabric. We can tile the material using the paint warp, the equalize, and the perspective crop to make the pattern seamlessly repeat. If you're interested to learn more about these filters, we have dedicated tutorials on our YouTube channel. At the end of the tiling process, we can use the clone stamp to remove small local imperfections and create seamless borders. To use it, click on the filter icon at the top of the layer stack and search for clone stamp. Then select clone stamp to apply it to the layer stack. In the 2D view, we can left-click and hold the Alt or Command Control key to set the clone source point. Let's paint over the imperfection to cover it with the previously selected area. All texture maps from the material will be stamped at the same time. In the parameter section, we can adjust the scale parameter to control the size of the clone stamp. The rotation parameter allows us to rotate the stamp to create more organic variations. The flip horizontal and flip vertical parameters can be used to mirror the stamp when needed. Once our clone stamp is positioned correctly, we can fine-tune the behavior of the mask. The mask expand parameter expands the mask size to find the most optimized cut path. A value of 0.5 will find the nearest most optimized cut for the mask. The new fade blending feature ensures a smooth transition between the background and the stamp area, preserving fine details. It uses Laplacian pyramid blending to intelligently hide seams. In some cases, we want to reduce the fade blending on some channels, like the base color in this case. We can control this per channel using the individual multipliers within the fade blending section. Lastly, the blur mask parameter softens the mask edges when needed. This is especially useful on some smooth materials, where blurring the stamp's edges helps maintain soft surface variations and frequencies. Let's explore another use case for the clone stamp tool. The clone stamp can be useful for creating seamless transitions at the borders of materials. Again, we left-click and hold the Alt or Command Control key to set the clone source point. Then, we paint over the vertical border of the map to cover the seam. Hold the Shift key to quickly draw lines. Then, we can refine the mask with the Expand Mask and Fade Blending parameters. Once that's done, we can tweak the horizontal scale by disabling the Keep Ratio option. Let's repeat the operation on the horizontal border. With all these new options, the clone stamp becomes a powerful tool for removing local imperfections or seams that disrupt the flow of your materials. Great! Our material is seamless now.
Alright, in this video we've seen the new features of the clone stamp. I hope you've enjoyed this overview. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more tutorial videos.